The obesity epidemic is going to have a huge social and economic cost. And if we can find a simple lifestyle that will not only prevent, but will also reverse obesity and diabetes, it will extend healthy lifespan with very little healthcare spending. When it comes to diet, weight gain, and diabetes, it's not just what we eat, but when we eat. In our previous study, we had shown that if we let mice eat only for 8 to 9 hours a day, those mice are protected from weight gain, obesity, and diabetes.
After the initial discovery, there was a couple of questions. We wanted to know if 8 hours was the magic number to maintain the beneficial effects of time-restricted feeding. And as this time-restricted feeding applies to the modern diet that is both enriched in fat, but also artificial sweeteners.
We let mice eat for 8, 9, 10, 12, or 15 hours a day, either a high-fat diet or a diet that's more similar to what we eat, which is moderately rich in fat and sucrose. We also asked if mice eat only 8 to 9 hours a day during the weekdays, and in the weekend they can binge it, then what happens? We're surprised to find that the benefits of time restriction persist even if the mice take the weekends off. We're also surprised to find the obese mice lost body weight, reduced blood sugar level to almost normal level, and had lower cholesterol.
So time-restricted feeding is efficient with already obese mice, it's efficient with different diets, and it's also efficient with different time limits.
What is very exciting about this is that it's much easier to adopt than most of the lifestyle modifications that people are recommended in doctor's offices every day. So with this type of therapy, you don't really have to calorie count. What really this works on is your own biology and letting your body use its own evolutionary developed metabolic pathways to shuttle energy appropriately.
It's also a powerful therapeutic way to reduce weight and reverse part of diabetes.
These findings are very exciting, but they're in mice. We need to do further experiments to make sure that they also lead to therapies in humans.